Israel's Iron Dome has saved countless lives since it was first put into action almost 10 years ago. Now, filmmakers are telling the amazing story of Israel's air defense system in a new documentary series. We've added our own voiceovers to some of the film clips. Take a look.
We're in the M3 district of Sderot. Here with us is Eli Moyal, mayor of Sderot, who came to the site in his slippers. He lives right around here. Eli, what did you hear?
I didn't hear it. I saw it. I saw the shells land, mortar shells land. It was an incredible sight. I called on Prime Minister Arik Sharon and the security cabinet. The answer isn't more shelters. The answer isn't taking cover. The Israeli government must stop the mortar attacks on Sderot.
That's how the search began for a solution to protecting Israel from rockets fired by terrorists.
Imagine a town with over 20,000 citizens. In the middle of nowhere, a shell lands without warning.
The new documentary series, Iron Dome, follows the development of this unique defensive system that has stopped 90% of the rockets it targeted.
We wanted to explore the story of the making of Iron Dome as a life-saving weapon system. And we found out that the story is much bigger than just an army system.
Creator and producer Nati Dinar says the series goes back to when the rockets started falling.
At the beginning, it was just all kinds of stupid rockets falling, nobody getting hurt. For the first time, when there were death casualty, people understood this threat is not a game. And one person named Danny Gold, who was in the Ministry of Security in charge of research and development, said, okay, we have to tackle this threat.
Dinar said the idea for the documentary started in 2015.
I wanted to meet Danny Gold and understand the story. I thought it was a one-man story. And here's this guy, he has an idea. He starts moving things along, and just like making a film, it's never about the guy having the idea and pushing it forward.
And with more than 100 interviews.
And at a certain point, we understood that the story is not about how rockets hit each other in the sky or how you develop them. This is a human story about people living in threat 24/7 and people trying to protect them, whether they are decision makers or engineers. And we eventually said we want to make an historic piece, but told in a personal way.
In 2006, Defense Minister Amir Peretz lived in Sderot, Israel's most targeted city.
Anyone who saw the damage caused by the Qassam rocket this morning at the Amit school in Sderot found it hard to describe the miracle.
Naturally, my house was the most common target. For Hamas, striking my house was a strategic decision. A picture of the Israeli Defense Minister's house being hit by a Hamas missile would be a great victory for them. One day, a missile landed a few meters from my house. A neighbor from the next street, who happened to be there, was killed. And my bodyguard, he was patrolling at the time. Both of his legs were blown off. I want you to know that your father is a hero of both Sderot and the State of Israel, and we won't pass over his death as if nothing happened. I don't think you did anything to prevent it. And my heart is broken.
The situation was so bad. We didn't have any solution against those rockets. Not Israel and not any country in the world, including the United States.
Around that same time, engineers and technicians at Rafael Advanced Defense Systems began work on the Iron Dome.
We decided to start to try to develop a system which we can intercept rocket during the trajectory in the air. It was almost impossible. But we understood that we don't have any other choice in Israel.
Born in Tel Aviv to Holocaust survivors, Levine brought a personal connection to his work on the system.
For me, it's, you know, to protect everyone in Israel. It's let's say I have it from the childhood.
First, we launch the target. The target's in the air. We start the countdown. The announcer, a guy named Dori, starts counting. Smoke comes out of the launcher. A missile blasts into the air. People are already applauding. I say, folks, there hasn't even been an interception yet. There are a few seconds of panic. Everyone's sitting there, glued to the computer.
Cheers for a defense system continuing to save Israeli lives today. The Iron Dome series can be viewed on Izzy, an international streaming platform some are calling the Netflix of Israel. Alpha Omega.